That is a fact. You do not appear on TV shows like this, chat shows or anything.
I don't know. I'm sure I've done something in 10 years, but I can't remember it, you know.
Is it a conscious effort that maybe you don't like answering questions? Just stay away from people who might ask questions?
No.
Yes, I'll get the one-word answers now.
Yes. No.
This is going to be really... Oh, thank you very much for coming, Linda.
You're very welcome.
You like a touch of this?
Yes, that's exactly what I need at the moment. You've got a film, you're working on Broad Street.
Yeah.
And it's not out yet, and it's not coming out for about another 9 months. Why?
True. We're still working on the music, doing the score, incidental music. No. And it's taking a bit of time, you know, and then they're going to release it, I think, spring of summer.
Mm-hmm. What's it about?
It's very like Olivia's film, actually. There's all this water, you see, and... No. What's it about, seriously?
Please.
It's the tapes to my new album go missing, and I've got a friend who works for me who used to be a criminal. And people suspect him, and I don't. And that's loosely the plot. And then I get into bed with John Travolta.
The end, though. When you're there with him, do you sing any songs in this film?
Yeah.
What sort of songs will we be hearing?
Some old, some new. Something borrowed.
Something new. Was it your idea to make the film, or was it one of these many suggestions you must receive?
No, it was, actually. I wrote it for my sins. So, yeah, it was my idea.
And you're in it as well, I believe.
Lynn.
Yes, I'm in it a bit.
Did he have to force you to take part, or was it something you'd always wanted to do?
Not really. John Travolta was a bit.
A bit iffy. Good. Very good.
You see why they didn't ask me for 10 years?
Yeah. Are you free in 1993? Maybe we could sort something out. Who's looking after the kids?
Right now.
And the sheep and everything.
Our eldest daughter. Mm-hmm. Can we wave?
Please.
Which camera? Hi.
Do you get much private life, much privacy?
Yeah, you have to take it, really, rather than ask for it, you know, so that probably is the serious answer to your question. That's why I don't do too many interviews. Because with the Beatles, we did everything we were ever asked to do. Mm-hmm. And that gets you where that got us. And if you do want private life, you have to retire a little bit from that position. As you well know.
Well, I nearly said I'd like to, but actually you've achieved a level of fame, a position that must be rather peculiar. Are you aware of walking through the studio and people actually going, I brushed against him, which it happened about half an hour ago?
No, not really.
Liar, somebody. Does it have any disadvantages for you, the fact that both of you are so well-known?
I don't think I'm as well-known. I actually can walk down the street and not get noticed.
Oh.
I'll try after tonight, you know.
The new song that you've got out has got a quite stunning film with it, and we're going to show that in just a moment. Working with Michael Jackson, I just wondered, because you came from a band, a group, is there something about needing people around you? I mean, you work with Stevie Wonder, and you've never really been totally solo.
Don't know, really. I suppose you could say that. Why I think I'm doing it is because I like working with a team. Mm. And with Michael, for instance, I just happened to know him through some song stuff that we got into. And I like him a lot. So he's very easy to work with. And he's fun to work with and stuff. So that came about that way. Stevie, it was one of my ambitions to work with somebody like Stevie, who's so great, that you've got to work hard to keep up with these fellas. You know, they're good. Mm. And I like that. It's, you know, working on a really good team is quite exciting. So I'm not sure if I need to be in a group, really, maybe.
Well, I certainly like the film we're going to see, because it's taken another twist, hasn't it? It's, I think, the first pop video, whatever you call it, where there is sort of like a little scene at the beginning. I mean, it's almost a total feature film.
The director said he wanted to do something a bit different, and he wanted to do this bit at the beginning, you know. And so it's his idea, really.
Hmm. Well, let's have a look at it for the benefit of anyone who hasn't seen it, which is just about the entire population. Say, say, say. Look, 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 look.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Gather round. Come on, gather round.
Step right up. Step right up. Come on, ladies and gentlemen, gather round. let me tell you all about the Mac and Jack Wonder Potion, guaranteed to give you unbelievable power. Yes, my friends, it can give you the strength of a raging bull.
I'll try one.
Here's a young gentleman. Like to try one. Yes, sir. Yeah. Drink it up. Let me help you with that, my friend. Try it.
Woo! Sir?
Yes.
Say, say, say.
actually have left the microphone on then, I think, because you were giving me a running commentary about everybody that was in the film. The producer, the directors.
They're all in it. It's done on the cheap.
Just say again, for the benefit of everybody else, who was in it?
Well, the director's the fellow playing pool, who I beat playing pool. The fellow handing the money is over is the producer. And all the people are all the local people.
So the old guy doing all
the old fella, yeah. He's, in fact, after the thing, he went to his head and he's never been seen since.
That's true, actually.
Whereabouts did you shoot it?
It was about an hour and a half outside Los Angeles in the Santa Ynez Valley.
I was just thinking back to this afternoon where you put me in my place because I said that Linda looked so scrumptious in the thing. You said, well, don't I look like that all the time? Just really put down by that. Do you...
Yes,
well, it was meant as a huge compliment. Do you find it hurtful ever when you read things that people say about you? Because you've been criticised as being overbearing
so.
And whatever.
I am.
She is, believe me. No, yeah, it hurts. Yeah. I think everyone knows it hurts. Anyone who's ever done any kind of interview, people get wrong. Or not so much wrong if they don't like something you've done. Mm. But you've just got to live with it.
What about challenges? Because I wonder whether... is there anything left for you as a challenge?
No, no.
It was a pretty naff question. No, quite right. That really was right at the bottom of the Parkinson drawer, that one.
I thought it was a good one, that. One of your better ones.
But you've done everything. I mean, what's life all
really.
About?
I haven't done anything, really. I mean, at the moment, I'm doing a film score. It's the first time I've ever done one of those. And there's actually lots of things I haven't done. Can't think of any right now, but... there are... No, I can never actually think of...
Go on. Ride a bull.
Ride a bull.
Ah, we could arrange it. You could abseil from a helicopter.
On the wheel?
Wallop.
Yeah. No.
Put your name up next
week. No, next week, maybe.
Quite nice. Like, celebrity version of that. Mm. No one big dream, no one big ambition.
Well, I mean, things like working with Stevie and Michael, that kind of ambition to, you know, I like working to with people who are inspiring. Mm-hmm. And in truth, I can never think of them when you ask me like this. You know, it's always going home in the car, oh, I could have told him that.
Is he a workaholic? Does he spend sort of all the time away?
No, he just works because he likes it. Like, I think all people work because they like doing something rather than just sitting around looking at the clouds. Mm. I like sitting around looking at the clouds. But
yeah, I mean, my thing's music, you know, so that's easy. It's not like work, really.
Yeah, exactly. It's a pleasure.
So, you know, there's moments when it can get very like work. Yeah. But... generally, out of the week, you know, most of the time I enjoy it. You know, don't have to go in, but I just like doing it. I like music and what it does to you.
Would you describe yourself as a good businessman?
Vaguely, maybe, but I'm more the music side and the creative side. There's people who work at our office who are better businessmen than me. I try and stay out of a lot of that.
And do you get a chance to sort of get away at all? I always have this Mullock entire vision of you in a cottage somewhere.
Yeah, we get away at least once a year to Scotland, yeah. Where we do love it there. But the work's down here kind of thing, and you've got to come in. So we get away, yeah.
Is he a good family man, then?
Not bad. No, he's good.
Especially when I'm asleep.
Great when he's asleep.
Well, I tell you one thing, I'm terribly grateful for you dropping in. I'm sorry if they were the worst questions you've ever faced.
No, they were really good.
In 10 years, I mean, what can you really expect? Ladies and gentlemen, Paul and Linda. Oh.
Now, anybody watching this programme very closely will know that we are missing one Whirly Wheeler because Alan Plummer's name came up on the wheel last week and we've been training him to be a magician, but because Paul and Linda agreed to come in, we've rejigged the programme somewhat. Do come in, Alan. Come in and say hello. How is your magic training going at the moment?
It's going very well. I've been training all week very hard. And I'll show you. Yeah, have a go at this. Take any card. That card is the Six of Hearts.
No, it's the Ten of Spades.
Sorry.
Oh, that
I'll try
good.
Again.
Yeah, go on then. Try again.
Paul, take a card. That card is a Two of Clubs.
No?
No, King of Hearts.
I'll get it right.
Yeah, well, you'd better train next week.
Yeah, I will, yeah.
Alan will be on the show next week. They won't, unfortunately. Thank you for joining me. Good night.